I think my favorite part about studying abroad in Rome is having every single day be a little adventure to do with Jesus.
Hi, my name is Madeline Salvador.
I'm Piloli Cherry.
I'm Christiana DiNardo George.
Hi, my name is Brooke Oliver. I'm a junior here at Ave, and my spring semester of my sophomore year, I chose to study abroad
last fall of 2022.
Spring semester of my sophomore year, 2022.
Spring of 2022.
So I did a little bit of travel before coming to Ave, but I knew I wanted to travel abroad again.
I am actually from Argentina, so just coming here was a culture shock in a sense. And since then I've been wanting to go to other countries to visit and learn from their culture. So I always knew that studying abroad was something that I was really interested in.
I called the school when I was applying and I asked if I could go because I'm actually a double major in math and physics, so I didn't know if that was something possible, but it was, and they worked with me and I was able to go.
I was talking to my advisor and we kind of worked out my entire four-year plan to fit in that study abroad program, and I went to an information meeting and realized that it would work out.
It was like the time of my life and I loved it, and it was really great to see the culture and the people and the food and just like the way that Italians live versus Americans. And I think study abroad was a really unique experience for that, because you're not just kind of like being a tourist, you're taking classes and you're experiencing firsthand what the city is like.
It's also where I feel like a lot of Catholicism is rooted in. Our villa where we stay in for the program is super close to St. Peter's Basilica. I mean, it's like less than a mile walk down. So we're going through St. Peter's every day. And to just think about where the saints were and where just so many doctors of our church have learned and where it was formed, it was just very inspiring to be there and to experience everything.
As we learn in class in theology here at the university, is that the church is universal. So then going abroad and going to mass or going to chapels with people that speak any other language, it's really cool to see how, even though they speak a different language and they have different ways of participating in the liturgy, is still the same church, and we're all worshiping God together.
In Rome, the classes that were offered when I went were humanities, poetry, art and architecture and theology, and so that was really cool because I didn't get to really like read that much about that, and then being in Rome and getting to read about these people who wrote these poems and things while in Rome was just like an amazing experience, because you could go look at the things that they were talking about. We read one poem that was about the Spanish steps, and then we got to go see them, which was just like an amazing experience.
The classes are super fun and super engaging. There's a professor who has lived in Rome for about, I want to say, 20 years, and so he knows all the ins and outs. And for example, our poetics class would a lot of times be just at a coffee shop, and we'd all talk about the poems we were reading over a cappuccino.
On the weekends, we'd get a three-day weekend, so Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and we got to travel kind of wherever we wanted, which was amazing.
I met people in Rome, and then we ended up doing trips together. So I was able to visit other countries like Spain, France, England, Croatia, and everywhere in Italy too. So that was probably my favorite part.
Picking my favorite memory from my Rome semester is absolutely impossible, because every single day was just so breathtaking. I think my favorite part about studying abroad in Rome is having every single day be a little adventure to do with Jesus. Not only do you get to experience really beautiful and cool things that you wouldn't normally get to experience, but you get to do it in a community where everybody is getting each other closer to Christ every single day.
Going to Rome, essentially, it makes like the faith aspect come to life. And you're literally walking where St. Peter once did. You're walking where St. Paul and Peter probably wrote something, and you're going by like the ruins and you're realizing, oh, St. Paul was in prison here, St. Peter was, and so on. But
It just is amazing having all of that come to life. It's like you're now not just reading it in the books and watching a PowerPoint about it. You're actually like right in front of it. And that was probably my favorite part.
My main takeaways are study abroad is really once in a lifetime. You're not gonna have, you most likely won't have another opportunity to just be with a group of people your age who speak English, who are experiencing Rome with you for the first time, and just living there. Like, it's very different to tour somewhere and live there, so I'm really grateful to have had the experience of actually living somewhere and getting accustomed to a different culture. I think that that's like developmentally really important, and so yeah, I'm really grateful. I highly recommend it.
The study abroad program at Ave Maria University is absolutely one of a kind, and I recommend it to anybody. So if you want an experience outside of the classroom that will form you not only as a person, but will form you incredibly spiritually, I 100%, 1000% recommend the study abroad program.
Go get the application, go to the meetings, ask questions, pray about it, but you won't regret it. This is the program for you.